A couple of years ago, government took $100 million loan facility from the World Bank to help improve capabilities in technical training institutions. These funds were used to implement the Uganda Skills Development Project, with a big portion going into infrastructure development and equipping the institutions. In addition to having poor infrastructure and insufficient equipment, the institutions had a challenge of inadequate transport to facilitate learning and service delivery. Now, through the Skills Development Project, the Ministry of Education and Sports has handed over 17 vehicles to 13 TVET institutions to transport students for training.
To the institutions to facilitate the work that must be done. That's the sole purpose of these vehicles. And you very well know that moving the trainees, our trainees in technical institutes to the world of work or industries has been a great challenge yet. Therefore, I urge the beneficiary institutions to be good stewards of what is being handed over to them.
In another development, Finca Uganda has handed over 1.3 million N95 face masks worth 1 billion shillings to the Ministry of Education in preparation to reopening other education institutions. This consignment has been donated to medical students to protect them from COVID-19 as frontline workers.
The thing that COVID has taught us, it has taught us to be ready with the technical, medical, human resource to fight any other endemic or pandemic that may arrive. And that's why we felt that when we give this donation, it should go towards supporting the human resource in the technical medical field.
The chairman, Parliamentary Committee on Health, Dr. Charles Ayume, emphasized that COVID-19 is about prevention, enforcing guidelines, plus complying to standard operating procedures.
The ministry works closely with the district health officers in ensuring that SOPs and other guidelines are enforced in the schools. We don't want to see a disparity between the district education officer and the DHO. I think that's what happened.
Janet Museveni said the nature of practical training of the medical students entails staying most of their time with handling patients, and this puts them at risk of exposure to various infections. She emphasizes that it is important for them to take personal safety against COVID-19.
The World Health Organization, it is estimated that about 180,000 health workers could have died from COVID-19 globally since the pandemic started. This grim statistic includes some health workers from right here in Uganda, because the Ministry of Health data shows that we have lost more than 50 health workers to COVID-19, and some of these contracted the virus while on duty. Therefore, it is important that as much as possible, our learners and trainees in these medical and health training institutions take personal safety against COVID-19 seriously.
The Ministry of Education and Sports continues to call upon children above 18 years and staff in tertiary institutions that were opened to go and get vaccinated against COVID-19. I'm Nafka Farida and Benadega in Kololo.